What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another episode of YouTuber Sculpting. My name is Banehorse, and today I have a magnificent bastard for you who is probably one of my favorite gameplay channels. His name is Sips. He's a member of the YouTube group called the Yogscast, who are YouTube broadcasters that all have different gaming channels. The Yogscast started back in 2008 with the game World of Warcraft, which is also where they get their name from. They later moved on to a well-known game by the name of Minecraft. The first time I heard of Sips was while I was watching a Minecraft series through the creators of the Yogscast channel called Lewis and Simon. The series that they were playing was called Tekkit. This was a really funny series, and if people like watching Minecraft Let's Plays with funny characters and storylines, check it out in the description. In the series, Sips is the boss of his company called Sipsco, along with his partner in crime, Shjin. Although in this series, Shjin is more of a lackey, Sips' business is making dirt, and the series eventually turn into corporate warfare between Sipsco and Lewis and Simon's factory, where they make Jaffa cakes. Anyway, the reason I find Sips so funny is because of how spontaneous his lines are. For a while now, he's expanded to playing various games such as Don't Starve, Skyrim, and Garry's Mod, just to name a few. He's got so many funny moments, and one of my favorites is when he's playing Garry's Mod with the rest of the Yogscast crew. And while the crew is having a deathmatch, you know, shooting the shit out of each other, Sips is just flying around in a bathtub not knowing what the hell is going on. He has many funny moments like that. Another reason I really enjoy watching his videos is because he plays a wide variety of games, from SimCity to Orcs Must Die. This is another channel that I like to have on while I'm working. He does long series, so when I'm sculpting for a long time, it's nice to put on the autoplay and watch some gameplay, since I don't usually get as much time to play video games as I would like. Now a little bit of trivia about Sips. Mr. Sips is married, and he has a son who the fans dubbed PoopFeast420, and a girl who the fans named Torbjorn. I hope I am saying that right. Apparently, he was also once a janitor. If you guys are interested in his channel, you can really start anywhere with any of his videos, but I'm going to tell you some of my favorites. So first off is pretty much any Minecraft video that he does with Shjin. The only bad thing about this is Sips got pretty burnt out a while ago playing Minecraft, so he doesn't really play the game that much anymore. Although he is in a series right now called Whale Lords. If you haven't checked it out, definitely take a look. Another favorite series of mine that he did was Don't Starve. I actually found out about this game because of his playthroughs. Don't Starve is a 2D-based survival game where not starving is just one difficulty you face, along with many more, such as going insane and getting attacked by the apparitions created from your mind. Some favorable moments for me is when Sips finds Old Laser Eye, which is a giant one-eyed bird thing, I guess. He has a few playthroughs of this game as different characters. I think overall, there are about 6 series where he plays this game, all really funny. Another game that he recently played that I loved was Firewatch. The story was really compelling, and although some Let's Play channels will only upload one video a day or a week, Sips was uploading like 3 to 4 videos a day for this game, which was really awesome because the story kept you on edge and wanting more, while Sips would chime in with his funny quips, which in turn made it even better. And finally, one of my favorite series is Garry's Mod, or Gmod. It's a little hard to explain to people who have never heard of the game before, but Garry's Mod is basically a physics-based sandbox game where you can build random things, and then if you want to, you can upload them to a Gmod library where people from all over can load the object you made into their game and check it out. I might have butchered that explanation, but if you're really curious about it, just check out the episodes that Sips made with the rest of the Yogs crew. Besides it just being a sandbox game where you can do f*** all, there are game mods that you can play, such as Murder, Trouble in Terrorist Town, and Prop Hunt. All really funny games, but my favorite is when they would just do the sandbox series. In the series, they just go through the Garry's Mod library, spawning in random objects they find and goofing around with them. So obviously Sips has many more series than the ones I have said, and let me know in the comments which is your favorite. Now, I will open my mind to let out the knowledge of how I decided to come up with the design for this sculpt. So if you Google Yogscast Sips, the first picture you will see is his most classic face pose. Most fans think of this when you say Sips. I figured it's his most recognizable pose, so why not sculpt that? I went with Sips' actual look rather than the Minecraft look or his cartoon character because...
Hi, buddy, I'll do what I want.
Actually, I really wanted to make a sculpt of the image where he's sitting in the chair in his bathrobe, and maybe someday I will do that. But anyways, I concentrated on getting his face to look correct because to me that's the hardest part when making any caricature. Then I was torn between whether I should make Sips in the sweatshirt that he's in the picture, or if I should have some fun and make a spacesuit. The reason for a spacesuit is because in his Minecraft videos, he is often in a spacesuit with white and blue details. I obviously picked this, and this was much more fun because I never made a spacesuit before. For his belts, I wasn't really sure what to do. I didn't know if I should have a crap ton of gadgets on his belt or what. I decided to go with the simpler look of just squares so that way I could make a kick-ass belt buckle, which you will see in the turnaround at the end. So overall, probably the hardest part of this sculpt was doing the wrinkles. It's a very time-consuming process just because you have to do a little bit of research and you have to know how the clothes fold over each other. Also, along with this, I had a certain style to conform to. Anyways, finally, we get... After about 3 days of consecutive sculpting, I have a nice steaming hot pile of Sips. For any of you wondering how I do the painting on these sculptures, I made a quick tutorial in another episode, so go check that out. Let me know what you guys think of this sculpt in the description, and also if you've ever watched Sips before, let me know what your favorite Sips moment is. I hope you all enjoyed this episode of YouTuber Sculpting, and if you did like it, please help me out by liking and subscribing to my channel. Anyways, I'm Banehorse, and remember to keep on creating.
Goodbye.